Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel IT Pro Teams. Today I would like to discuss about one of the amazing feature that introduced by Microsoft in Microsoft 365 platform, and this feature is helpful for the people who are managing on-prem infrastructure, especially if they have to manage the printers. The feature is called Universal Print. With the help of this Universal Print, we can able to manage all the printers from cloud itself without any server. Another advantage of this is that you're not only registering your printers with Universal Print service of Microsoft 365, you also manage them from there. You can also have the option in the cloud itself where you can give the permission for the cloud user. So if you go to your admin center in down, you'll be able to see this option. If you click on that link, then it will take you to this particular portal. So how we are going to implement it? So there are three-step process. First step process, we need to have a connector. So currently, you see, I have created one demonstration connector here. Then we need to have a printer, and then we have a printer sharing options. So currently, you see, I don't have any printers or printer sharing options. I do have one test connector, which I created in earlier. So if you want to do it, you have to first download this connector. Click on this link, it will take you to Microsoft website, right? And under that Microsoft website, you'll able to see there is an option called Universal Print Connector Installer. You click on it, this will start downloading. So what exactly, if you have to install it, what you need, right? You need an internet connectivity, which I have, and you need a global admin or printer admin rights, which I have, right? So let's go to this software and let's try to install it. So now I have started the setup. Once you start the setup, you'll able to see the screen in front of you, accept the license agreement, then click on install. And then your installation starts. Before I go there, I need an user ID who will have the appropriate permission. So I'll go to my users and I search for my global admin on my admin account. So I'll use it. So this is my admin account. It's a test tenant only for demonstration purpose. So let me copy this global admin account. Let's go back. The setup has been successfully completed. It will ask you to launch it. Once you click on the launch, just wait for a few moments and then you'll able to see this screen in front of you, right? And here you'll able to see it will ask you to start the print services. First you just click on the login. When you click on the login, it will ask you to supply your user ID and password. So you just supply your global admin account and the password of that account. You can create a print administrator role also. Once you do that, it start loading the information like this. Okay. So currently I have a connector, right? I do have some available printers. Diagnostic is on, but hybrid AD is off because I don't have a hybrid AD. Right. So now you can see I do have some printers available in my computer, And these two available printers, which are the part of connected or configuring this, I want to register to my cloud infrastructure. So currently, if you can see, there is no registered printer available here, right? So what we have to do, we have to select, and then there is an option called register. Once you do that, if it will pass or fail, you'll able to see the status here. Currently, it's an in progress. And once the progress is completed, you'll able to see that printer move from available printers to the registered printer. Now you can see this printer is successfully moved here. Same way, I can select another printer. I click on it. So the only conditions for the machine where you're going to install this particular service, the printer need to be locally configured. It could be any machine. It could be Windows 10 or Windows 11 machine as well. Doesn't matter for the print service. Once this is done, you'll able to see second printer also part of here. So I have two printer added here. So once you do that, you just, if you can see any failed, there's a retry option, you want to abort pendings or clear the failed one, here it's done. Once you complete it from here, right, you just come back to this informations and you just click on the printers. Now you'll able to see the status of those printers. So I have added two printers 1 minute back, and you see one printer is ready, one printer is stopped. That means this printer might be not online as of now, might be. So you can see complete detail of the printers, but you don't see the printer, right? It's shut down, right? You can see the status. Okay, so you can see the option refresh, share and unregister the printer, right? If any job is coming, you can see all the jobs from here. You can manage them. You can go to the property of the printers and you can set the different options, right? Printer default properties, right? Job related, right? How you're going to manage the queue, direct print or QR based, code based printing, right? And then you'll able to see the connectors, the connector that I have created. And here you're able to see from which host name the printer connector is configured, right? You can see what is the operating system, right? And when the date and time when it will register. Now go back. So same thing is, this printer is ready, right? And you can see the status. Status is, no, status is ready, but not shared. So you have the option. You can go back here and now you see there's no user has access on this particular printer. Now, if you want to give someone to permissions, you need to share it, right? So there's an option. You can do it from here or you can click on the printer. You can do it from there. Let's click on this. Once you click on this, you'll able to see if this printer will be available for the entire organizations. You can select this option, or you want only a selected person to be the part of that printer, right? Or a group or anything. Let me add one particular person, right? When I click on it, right, the status will be changed here, right? Now it's not shared. It changed it from not shared to shared. And if you click on that printer, right, then you'll able to see. The printer is shared, and then you can have the option if you want to delete the sharing of this particular printer. Status is changed from not shared to shared. So this is the way you are able to install a connector for your universal print service in any computer, and you can register your printers, and once the printer is registered, you'll able to share them. and then people will have the access and they're able to take the printout. If you go here, if anyone is taking the printing, right, you'll able to see, right, how many printers are there, how many printers are shared, how many connectors are there. You can have one connector or more than one connector. So let's suppose each office you'll have one connector available, so you can configure it. And then you see if you want to download the reports, you can download the printer users reports and user uses report also. So with printer users reports, you'll able to see how many print jobs has been taken by one printer, and user reports can tell you who all are the users use that printer to take the printout. So if you can go to your settings, then here you can able to see if you want to have some global settings, document conversion, right? And then Mac OS support preview also available. So that means it's not only for Windows, it also support the Mac, right? So here is the option, hide the partially supported printer or show all printers or disable or enable, how you want to enable the settings, right? So currently printers without all advanced settings, right, and status will be hidden from Mac users. So partially hide Mac. Mac will not able to see, but Windows people will able to see it. If you have any issues with this particular service, you can go to the support and you're able to request for the support. This is the end of this video. Thank you guys for watching it, and we'll see you in the next video. Thank you very much.